Hi everyone, it's Gus from Power My Life Up, and today I'll be taking you through all the steps to setting up WordPress on the Raspberry Pi. WordPress is a content management system, or CMS, that is used by millions of websites. It is hugely popular amongst bloggers and is used by many large websites. Setting up WordPress on the Raspberry Pi is not hugely complicated, especially once you have Apache, PHP, and the MariaDB server set up. In this tutorial, I will be using a Raspberry Pi 5 running the latest version of Raspberry Pi iOS Bookworm. First, either SSH to the Raspberry Pi or open the terminal on it. Update the package list by entering sudo apt update. Now upgrade any out of date packages by entering sudo apt upgrade -y. We will need to first install Apache. You can do this by entering sudo apt install apache 2-y. First, we want to add our user to the www data group. You can do this by entering sudo usermod -a -G www-data $user in all uppercase. We will need to make further permission changes when we install WordPress, but for now, this will do. Enter sudo reboot to have the user group update take effect. There are a few extra steps that we'll need to take to prepare Apache for WordPress. These steps are important if you want to use the WordPress custom permalink settings. Firstly, we must enable the rewrite module for the Apache web server. You can do this by entering sudo a2-en-mod rewrite. Once that is done, we must restart the Apache web service by entering sudo systemctl restart apache 2. Now we need to allow the wordpress.ht access file to override Apache's default config. To do this, open up the Apache 2 main config file by entering sudo nano /etc/apache2/apache2.conf. Within this file, we will need to find the directory configurations. The easiest way to do this is to press Ctrl W, then search for the allow override setting. This will get us to roughly where we need to be. Find the block that has the settings for the /var/www/directory. Find the allow override setting and change it from none to all. Once you're happy with the changes, press Ctrl X, then Y, and then Enter to save and exit. Now we need to restart Apache by entering sudo systemctl restart apache 2. To ensure that Apache has restarted correctly, you can run the same command again, but replace restart with status. For example, sudo systemctl status apache 2. Now we need to install PHP so the web server can run WordPress correctly. For this tutorial, we will be using PHP 8.2, as that's the version that is readily available on the current version of Raspberry Pi OS. In the future, you may be able to change 8.2 to a newer version. To install PHP, enter sudo apt install php 8.2 libapache 2-mod-php 8.2 php 8.2-mbstring, php 8.2-mysql, php 8.2-curl, php 8.2-gd, php 8.2-zip, then lastly -y. Now that's php installed. We will now need to install a database that WordPress can use. For this tutorial, we will be using MariaDB. To install MariaDB, simply enter sudo apt install MariaDB-server. With the MariaDB server software installed on the Raspberry Pi, we will now need to secure it. To do this, enter the command sudo mysql underscore secure underscore installation. For the first prompt, you can simply press enter. I don't want to use Unix authentication, so I will enter N. I want to update the root password for MariaDB to something else, so I will enter Y. I will now enter my new password and then enter it again. I want the anonymous user removed, so I will enter Y. I don't want the root user to be able to log in remotely, so again, I will enter Y. I want to remove the test database and access to it, so again, I will enter Y. I want to reload the privileged tables, so I will enter Y. Now that's the MariaDB server set up, and we can now move on to installing WordPress to the Raspberry Pi. To install WordPress, let's first move to the HTML directory by entering /var/www/html. We will now want to fetch the latest version of WordPress. You can do this by entering sudo wget https://wordpress.org/latest.tar.gz. Now we need to extract the archive by using the tar command. We will do this by entering sudo tar xzf latest.tar.gz. The xzf are options we use to tell the tar command what to do. X is to extract the file, z is to use a gzip algorithm, and f is to specify the file. Now we want to move our extracted contents out of the WordPress directory and into our HTML directory. You can do this by entering sudo mv wordpress/*/. Now you want to remove the WordPress directory and the zip file we no longer need. To do this, enter sudo rm-rf wordpress/latest.tar.gz. Now we want to make sure all our permissions are set up correctly. We want all our files to be owned by the WW data group. So we will need to enter sudo chown-r-f www-data:/var/www/html. We want to set the directories and files so they have the correct read, write, and execute permissions. For directories, we will set 755, and for files, we will set 644. To update all the directories to 755, enter sudo find dot hyphen type d hyphen exec chmod 755 curly bracket slash semicolon. To update all the files to 644, enter sudo find dot hyphen type f hyphen exec chmod 644 curly bracket slash semicolon. That's all the permissions now set correctly. We'll test this a bit later. Lastly, let's remove the example Apache HTML index file by running sudo rm index.html. Now we need to create a database for the WordPress installation to connect to. First, change your directory back to home by entering cd tilde. Now let's log into our MariaDB server by entering sudo mysql hyphen u root hyphen p. The password is the same one we set earlier in this tutorial. We are now in the MariaDB prompt, so let's create our database. Create database WordPress semicolon. Now we need to create a user that will have access to this database, as we do not want to use our root user. So enter create user single quote w underscore user single quote at single quote localhost single quote identified by single quote your password single quote semicolon. Both the username and password should be updated to something unique. Just make sure you remember them, as we'll need them later in the tutorial. As you can see, I use wp underscore user as the username and pymylifeup as the password. We now need to grant access for our user to be able to access the newly created database. You can do this by entering grant all on wordpress.*to single quote wp underscore user single quote at single quote localhost single quote semicolon. Again, make sure you update WP underscore user if you're using a different username. Now that's all done, we can safely exit by pressing Ctrl D. Lastly, we'll need to get the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. You can do this by entering hostname hyphen capital I. Our IP address is the first one in the list. Now open up your favorite web browser and go to the IP address. In my case, it is 192.168.0.15. You'll be greeted with a setup page. Select the language you wish to use. In my case, I'll be using English. You will now see a screen that explains what you'll need to set up WordPress. Luckily, we have already done all this, so let's click Let's Go. Enter the database name. In our case, it is simply called WordPress. The username of the database, for me, it is WP underscore user. The password is the one we set for our user. In my case, it is PyMyLifeUp. Database host and table prefix shouldn't need to be changed. Now click submit to have the initial checks run. If everything looks good, you should see this page. Simply click run installation to have WordPress perform its first setup. Now we need to enter all the details of our website and our admin user. Simply fill out all the relevant fields. Once you're ready to proceed, click install WordPress. Once it is finished setting up, you should see the login page. Simply log in using the admin user you just created. If you see the dashboard, you have successfully set up WordPress. To make sure our permissions are correct, go to the update page and test updating a plugin. If it successfully updates like this one, then your permissions are likely correct. If you see an FTP prompt or an error, your permissions may be incorrect. If you wish to allow external access to the WordPress instance, you can install something like Cloudflare Tunnel or Tailscale. These are probably the easiest way to create a secure route to your setup. However, you could also set up port forwarding. This is a little more complicated and a bit more of a security risk. I hope this tutorial has helped you set up WordPress on the Raspberry Pi. If you liked this tutorial and would love to see more, please click like and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.